Are there any changes to today's agenda?
We've got this.
We passed it around.
Anybody get first?
Right now, there is only one item on the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to take this opportunity to again accuse myself of being involved in discussion on this matter today.
Thank you. I take that as no changes to the agenda of any kind. Is there a motion to adopt the agenda as it is?
So moved.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0. And the item is the City County Raw and Finished Water IGA County Attorney. And welcome back from
Thank you.
Europe.
Thank you. Appreciate that. It's good to be home. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, in my absence, I know that you all had a brief update with respect to the raw and finished water contracts at your last regular meeting. And I know that I requested this meeting today, so thank you, first of all, for the accommodation in allowing this to go forward. I felt like it's time for you all to get sort of a comprehensive update on where we are and why we do not have an IGA yet. Hopefully we will, but yet. And sort of just tell you where staff and I have been at and what we have proposed and what I think is on the table, if you will. As you know, and I'll just give you a brief chronology just so everybody sort of can catch up with where we are. On May 22nd of this year, the Board of Commissioners approved as a binding proposal to the City of Cumming a list of bullet points or criteria for the extension of the raw and finished water contracts. That was the next day delivered to the City of Cumming for their consideration. And then the following day, on May 24th, the county received a letter from the City of Cumming agreeing to the terms, subject to the placement of those terms into an intergovernmental agreement. Following that, on June 8th of 2012, the City of Cumming took a first draft at a proposed IGA that would memorialize the terms of what we had put together. And the City Attorney and I met about that on June 11th, which was the following Monday, and sort of walked me through their proposed IGA language. And I will tell you that and I've discussed this with you, that the IGA proposed by the City of Cumming was a little more, it did some things with respect to the IGA that I thought made some sense as far as trying to make it a little more of a expansive IGA that would maybe close up some of the loopholes and some of the language that may have needed to have been closed up. But it wasn't exactly where I thought it needed to be as far as what I could bring to you, and that was fine because that was a first draft, and I understand that's the way a negotiation works. I then met with staff on multiple occasions going through the language, trying to prepare a red line, which was anticipated by the city. And in fact had a red line that I delivered back to the city on June 25th, which contained what we thought was language that took their draft, but otherwise modified it to make it consistent with what I believe the county had prepared. Commissioner LeBanc.
You skipped from May 24th to the following Monday with a Senate mm-hmm. draft. You were redlining June 25th?
Yes.
Already?
6/8, 6/11, 6/25.
Yes, right? June 11th is when I met with the city attorney and sat down with the city attorney. June 25th is when I sent back what I believe was consistent based upon their draft with the board's bullet points.
Okay.
So that was June 25th. On June 28th, the city provided back to me their response to our red line, which was that they didn't agree with a lot of it. And that's the way that went. So that was on June 28th. And then on July 11th, I did something a little different. I took another shot at it from a little bit of a different perspective, and that is Sometimes when you're putting together something that's sort of elaborate and sort of complicated, perhaps one way to approach it, if you're not getting a lot of success doing that, is to perhaps just take a step back and try something maybe a little more less elaborate. And what I tried to do was therefore mimic almost exactly what you all had agreed to on May 22nd. And that's what I did. So basically what you agreed to on May 22nd was to approve the existing raw and finished IGAs, right? That's what we approved, subject to about 4 or 5 bullet points changing each. And so when you took a step back and tried to do that, it's a lot less elaborate of an IGA, and perhaps it's not as perfect as we would like. I think that you all understand that for years there has been a thought of perhaps rewriting these and making them, some of the language make a little more sense and this and that, but this may not be in the environment to do that. And so my goal was to try and bring back a more streamlined document that goes right to the heart of what the board approved and presented that to the City of Cumming. And I have now received some comments back with respect to that proposal, and I think that's what I want to share with you today. In fact, what I have handed out to you is what I delivered to the City of Cumming on July 11th, which is what I, again, am calling this sort of streamlined IGA that sort of distills the points as narrowly and as focused as I can to what you all approved. Okay, obviously that's the direction of the board, and I need to try and bring this home pursuant to your directive. The two primary comments that I have received, and would it help, by the way, do you all want to go over the bullet points? Do you all want to go over that real quick?
I would like to, yeah.
All right. On May 23rd, we sent a letter to the City Administrator, Gerald Blackburn, that basically adopted the finished water. Right? Our vernacular is the raw, there's the raw and finished water. The actual contract term is a little different than that, but it's the raw and finished water. That the finished water contract would be renewed as is, subject to the following modifications. The price would be $2.25 per 1,000 gallons for finished water. Remember, this is as is, so there's a lot of language that as is captures. Okay. The price would be $2.25 per 1,000 gallons. The term of the finished water component would be a 5-year initial term with a 5-year option at the discretion of the county. And then the third element of that was simply that inconsistent, contradictory, or already fulfilled terms in the finished water agreement would be stricken. And that was simply to hopefully ensure that to the extent we had two provisions that were conflicted or were contradicted, we could take those off. Okay. And there are a few of those. The primary one, you may ask, well, what are those terms? The primary one is that it is anticipated in these IGAs that we're going to be working together to try and get our permit increased. And a lot of the language in the finished water agreement and the raw water agreement too speak in terms of those percentages staying static. And if we're going to have a document that's supposed to survive for 10 or even 30 years, and all the time we're getting new allocations from the state, that document needs to at least be flexible enough to match that, because it's very likely that our percentage will increase. So that was one of the things. So those were the terms as to the finished agreement. With the raw water agreement, there was an initial, first of all, it was approval as is, raw water agreement approved as is, for a 15-year term, with a 15-year option for renewal, again, in the discretion of the county. Item two was the city will make available to Forsyth County an additional 4.5 million gallons of raw water based on a 30-day average from the city's allocation to be purchased at the county's discretion. That was element number two of the raw water agreement. And then just like the finished water agreement, any inconsistent, contradictory, or already fulfilled terms would be stricken. So those are the two elements.
Just the terminology of that, I thought it was when available.
Not in the bullet points. I have the motion. So let me see. The minutes reflect the same thing. You purchase at the county's discretion. Now, I will tell you that throughout the course of the discussions leading up to that, there was always language talking about when it is available from the city.
Thank you.
Is there not a bullet point about $11 million or thereabouts?
That's my next point. In addition to adopting the raw and finished water contracts as is subject to those modifications, there was also language pertaining to the intake. Forsyth County agreed to tender to the City of Cumming $11,436,450.13 within 30 days of approval of an IGA that would constitute payment in full of invoice, the invoice sent over by the city to the county. As consideration for that payment, the county stated that with respect to any requests from either the city or the county to the state EPD, the U.S. Army Corps, or other regulatory agency for a surface water withdrawal permit, or any sort of like permit from any appropriate regulatory agency for capacity over and above the existing $37 million joint allocation now, the City of Cumming and Forsyth County will work jointly and cooperatively to ensure that Forsyth County receives the greater of, and there were two elements, one, the full extent of any additional allocation proposed by the Metro North Georgia Water Planning District, May 2009 edition, or two, 65% of any increase, it being the intent of the city and county that at that point when the maximum capacity of the water is flowing through the intake structure, that the county will be receiving 68 MGD of that water. And sort of like associated with that was that to the extent that we needed to petition EPD, we could literally tender the IGA as the city's consent for that enhanced allocation. In other words, we didn't need to go back and get additional permission. The IGA was that permission. The IGA was that consent. So that was the final term with respect to the payment for the intake. What I handed out to you this evening is my draft of an IGA that is not terribly ambitious. Okay. It adopts the raw water and the finished water IGA that's been in place for years and years, subject to the changes I just went through, the 5 and 5 year for the finished, the 15 and 15 for the raw, the 225 rate on the finished. I have taken care of any inconsistent or contradictory terms. I have filled in language providing for the $11 million payment. I have made sure that we can make a unilateral request to EPD for an increased permit. I have added some language that provides that to the extent the raw and finished water IGA do not contain floating allocation percentages, they will now, but it's modest. It's not a radical rewrite of what we already have in place now, because I tried to get it as close to the bone as I could, which was my objective. And we have received some feedback from the city with respect to that. And again, I say proposal, but I say proposal only in the term of describing what it is. The proposal was your proposal. This is just my way of explaining it to you. Really, of the feedback I've gotten, there's two primary points that I want to focus on, because the rest is just lawyer speak back to me, and it's things that I feel are already taken care of in the agreement. The two substantive components are this. Number one, I want to focus very quickly on the raw water agreement. Okay. The way this would work would be the agreement right now, if it was adopted by the city and the county, is that the county would receive the 16 million gallons of its allocation, right? We have a 16 million gallon component of the allocation from the surface water withdrawal permit. We would get that at basically cost, which is around 10 cents per 1,000 gallons, okay? And that's not a fixed number. That number could go up or it could go down, but it's roughly 10 cents per 1,000 gallons. All right, well, you remember that the raw water agreement also contained this language, that they will provide an additional 4.5 million gallons out of their allocation, right? And that's raw water. So they would provide us an additional 4.5 million gallons out of their allocation. The city does not believe that the terms as proposed by the county contain language on what that additional 4.5 million gallons will cost. In other words, what is the rate that you all are going to be charged for the additional $4.5 million? The bullet points did not speak precisely to that issue. As it was delivered under the auspices of the raw water component, however, I believe the belief of the Board of Commissioners was the additional $4.5 million would be paid for, if you will, at the cost, the 10 cents, that floating cost. The City of Cumming has proposed something different for that. They have proposed $1.25 per 1,000 gallons for that additional raw water.
While we're on that subject, if you will, in your opinion, the way it's written and the way you believe it, man, it was clear enough that all raw water would be at that cost, no matter whose permit it came off of. And I have one question to follow that up with.
The bullet points, Commissioner Levant, do not speak directly to that, but the raw water, it was under the raw water section, and the raw water section contains one price number.
That's right.
What does as is mean in this case?
Well, as is, let me explain this. The existing raw water agreement doesn't address this issue either.
The existing one, page 2, 4C?
The existing, well, the one that's expired.
And in that,
well, yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
The 4C does talk about 16 MGD.
Right.
As the limits, so.
That's right.
Well, let me ask you, the standard's been over the years. Have we ever gone over that 16 MGD per day? We never gone over that yet?
What's the most raw water we've taken?
In a day.
This year, with the improvements, we've been able, I don't have the spreadsheet, but we had 16 May, and change.
Before that, yeah.
How much do we, you
before
remember
the
spreadsheet?
Came on.
30-day average, we usually bring in around 14 okay. MGD, because that's 30 days. We just kept it running steady. That's our max month allotment, so 14, maybe a little over, maybe up to 15.
Never over 16.
Yeah. We don't have a permit for it.
I understand. And my next question to follow up my first one would be, based on needs, do y'all believe the EPD's rules or what they guide themselves by are the future ones that will be more set in stone now are more based on permits are supposed to be based on needs than they are wants, and that they are swapping and changing the allocations between municipalities because of that? As one municipality may shrink in population and one may grow. And my fear is that the EPD, by shorting us on our side and forcing us to buy raw water and allowing us to be charged at a much higher rate by the city for just pumping the same water to us, when what really EPD should do based on the rules is give us additional permits, and then it won't be an issue.
Well, I think that we definitely need to do that, but that still doesn't really answer the question about how do we resolve the, we ask to renew as is with 16 MGD. Doesn't really relate to the permitting. It doesn't talk about permit limits. It talks about 16 MGD. So if we could pump 20 or 22, that's fine. But did we, in fact, renew a 16 MGD while we were contracted?
Then we said we wanted an additional
4.5.
That's correct. But we didn't then state additional fees or any money. We still have a raw water amount, which we offered to pump. Well, raw water, period.
We just didn't contemplate the price of the additional water.
Yeah.
But if you look at it, you know, originally we started talking about this. I wanted us to get additional finished water, but I don't think the board was comfortable with that. But if they guarantee an extra $4.5 million in raw water, we pay $1.25 for it, we finish it arguably for 60 cents, then we're getting it at $1.85. If you're getting an up to $4.5 million a day, you're committed to buying $4.5 million at $2.25. The average cost of water then, if you buy 9 million gallons, is $2.05 a thousand. And it's at our option. It's just an insurance policy. That's all it is.
And it is $2.05 versus what, $2.50 is what it's been adjusted.
But they accepted selling us that water off of their raw herbicide. And the only amount was ever discussed in our motion was starting at the approximately 10 cents a thousand.
He's not saying that. The price, he's got the price, I hate to put you on the spot, but that's why we're talking about it. Because the price for the additional 4.5 was never contemplated.
It was to me.
I believe it was contemplated on the
trip. I gave them a raw water price and a raw water price.
Then are they violating the terms we sent over?
No, I don't think they're violating the terms that we sent over there.
So, to your point, that's why we're talking about it.
And I think it's a.
I still think we made two offers of prices. One was finished and one was raw. To me, it's not that complicated.
That's right, but we renewed the existing contract as is, and the existing contract speaks to 16 million gallons a day. Now, if we have the capacity for more, we're going outside of that 16 million.
That's kind of an add-on.
And it's their capacity that we are getting a right to.
I agree with that. And I agree as is with the additional changes was 4.5 million gallons. That we still only had one price for our water that we offered.
Is that what we sent over? As is with following modifications.
Because even on the additional water that you put down to be purchased and finished, we also agreed to 2225 of that as well. It's one price for finished and we offered one price for raw is all we did. And we put additional amounts on each one, but there's still one price for each is all we ever offered.
That's not what we offered. You'd be telling us they're not complying with what we set over.
Do you feel that the first IGA or the red line version the city sent back to us complied with our motion, the spirit of it, or in line with our motion?
Did they
add things in there that weren't even a part of it and twist it all up?
It was a little bit different.
Is this one that we're on now today?
No. Okay. One we're on today is
they
in my opinion very consistent with what the board had approved.
And they've seen this. And they've commented.
So they're commenting. Let's continue talking. You said there's two substantial.
This is the first one. The issue is the price for the additional 4.5 million gallons of raw water.
And just one point. If we go on to get more than 4.5, there's no addition. We're back to the wheeling fee. This is just the 4.5 that's in their allocation that we're getting from them.
And what is that amount they want?
$1.25 a thousand for 4.5 million gallons. Up to 4.5 million gallons a day on a 30-day average.
So we treated 12 to 12 and a half times the amount that we pay for cost.
Maybe we should take it out.
Tim, I still don't on this issue. I still don't have a good feel for where we really are in terms of your emails of, we're bumped up against our limits. And regardless of the price, whether we need, how often we are going to need the 4.5 million gallons?
Well, when we might need it.
Because you've already got your
interest. Our max number on a 30-day average is 14, and then 16 on the max day. Looking at the max day, then under the contract from 99, we're supposed to be able to get 7.54 million gallons of finished water. So 16, another 7, we're getting we're a little over 20, making 21. We've had a day. Those are the max numbers. We've had a 21 million gallon day already this year, actually 22. It didn't last but about a week. We're back down, so.
It's very short lived.
Very short lived.
So it's not a 30-day average.
There's a few times this year we would have dipped into that 4.5. Probably, I could go down and get the spreadsheet if I could dial in here. Would you guess not more than 7? Days.
But don't you also have a 20 million reserve tank?
And how much?
We can manage the reserve tank to eliminate that some. We like to keep that for emergencies. We don't like to really utilize that, but you could. We could cut back
to 1.2. What do you think you would have gone over? What do you think you would have gone over on those 7 days? Roughly a couple million or a million?
It really depends on how much we're able to get finished water from the city. That's the key. If, and as their system grows, we keep having the ability to get less and less. We have a hard time getting 7.54 now. A lot of times it's only 6. So that means we've got to get, we'll dip into it even further. That puts us at 20. So then we may have to get 2 or 3 million. So
2 or 3.
And the key is whether or not the city can deliver the finished water, and if that diminishes.
No, I'm just trying to get to the...
Right now, we have a guarantee of 4.5 million.
We're not going to need that 4.5 MGD on a day-to-day basis.
The contract is not at 4.5. That's an annual average number. I think the current contract is, it's more in the summer. It's not a 4.5 max.
When we hit 104 degrees, water has been used.
Yes. And we were getting, I think the peak day I've seen from the city was up around 7 finished water, which is consistent with what we've always done. We've always got more finished water from them in the summer months, less in the winter. We've got a curve that we try to hit with the monthly amounts. This is what they gave us and after we signed that contract with the monthly targets that we try to hit.
Go ahead, Commissioner, forgive me.
It's safe to say that we would only be using out of this 4.5 MGD, 1 million to 3 million a day for, 10 to 15 days a year?
Let's go start out at that. Now, that's a good guess. Looking at the current demands next year with the growth, it'll go up every year.
But the 4.5 million gallons is on based on a 30-day average. We may never hit that on a 30-day average.
True.
But if we're buying that at $1.25,
it's cheaper.
It's better than buying the finished water.
Much better.
That we're buying now. See, because we can treat it ourselves now.
We have full all of our permits in order as a plant. Completely open with all permits in place right now.
The EPD is processing the operations permit for the additional 12. Once the plant's finished, everything's submitted, they're working that. That's just an operational to let you run it at the higher rate. The withdrawal permits have not been changed yet. The EPD's starting some discussions about that. I expect that they're going to be considering increasing withdrawal permits as needed. We've been told that we were first in line. As soon as the attorneys for the state tell them what they can do, South County will be the first one they work on as far as
in which case this is moot.
No, exactly. Now, is it, do you think it's an important point for us to send a resolution from this board voting asking for it?
Yes.
I don't think, just to clarify that, I don't think we need to get into a take from the city and give to the county.
I've been invited to a meeting Thursday that the EPD director will be at with all the water district water managers at the ARC, and the EPD director is going to be discussing where they think they are with permit requests.
What do you suppose the amount is that we should ask for to take us in the next 15 or 20 years? And what should that amount be for increase?
We've got a permit request in for the next, I forgot what it is, it's like, 25 years that it's in the EPD's hands. I don't know if they're going to want to process in the interim the long range request right now, if they're going to scale everything back. The last thing they want to do is get Florida and Alabama upset to file another lawsuit of some kind. So I foresee them giving some interim increases to the ones in need. They've already recognized that we are in need more than anybody else. And I see them giving us some increase. I don't know if they'll give us our full request.
You don't know what that amount was that we want to ask for.
They have it here.
No pressure. I would love to know that.
But to say it a different way, who else are they going to sell this 4.5 million gallons to but us? At any price.
It's an insurance policy for us.
Yeah, we need to have it available in case we need it.
Where do you suppose the $1.25 came from?
I have no idea.
That's a number I haven't heard ever yet.
But it's only for 4.5 million because it takes it away from their allocation.
I understand. That they could treat and sell somebody
for
more money.
That's right.
I understand. And they figured out what their profit value was in there, and they're trying to get it that way.
But the fact is, we don't use that much. It's just not.
Ken, since we're sort of looking at this pretty closely, the city shall make available Forsyth County an additional 4.5 million gallons. Do we know that that additional meant on top of and after the as-is allocation?
Yeah, I think the expectation of the board was that that was over and above the 16 million they provide that was already part of our allocation. And I think that the board at least implicitly believed that it would be at the same rate. You know, otherwise, I think y'all would have carved out a price term.
I just want to make sure that somehow what appears to be additional meaning on top of or after the other is consumed doesn't somehow become it's additional, but you have to take it first every day.
Right, yeah.
Okay. I don't have the permit applications with me, but I'm 95% sure it's 40 million gallons a day, right around 40 total. Million total. Okay. That's what we asked for out of the lake.
Out of the lake. And
that's before we split it. Then after that, we split some of that off to a river request.
Total was 52.
We've got two applications in. We wouldn't get the 40.
54 and 2000. And your 2000 was a total of 54 million gallons a day.
That's city and county.
Right. That's what they are.
I wanted to just go
But the original request to the lake alone that we made was right at 40.
Ken, how can I draft that into a motion that we do offer up a resolution since I don't know the exact amounts?
I'm not sure
that we need to ask for.
I think that's something we'd have to put on the
note. You mean as far as the next for an EPD permit?
Is it appropriate to make a motion to have a resolution in EPD on this water since that's what
we're talking about? It's not really for this agenda because that wasn't advertised.
Okay.
It's a fair
if
question.
If he wants to put it on the
I can get those.
Happy to.
Well, downstairs. I mean,
yeah, that's definitely.
If he wants to put it on another work session, I'll second
it. I do. And he's a second, so let's definitely get that going.
I mean, as long as it's a clear and concise that
for us. Whenever all right. We get ours, we can see
more. I don't think it's done.
You want to go through the second? Because I think it may add some clarity
right.
With respect to with what the second component. Okay, the first component, just to be clear, is with respect to the 4.5 million gallons of raw water over and above our allocation and over and above our mandatory finished water purchase. They're asking that that price be $1.25. I'm telling you what I thought you all believed. And Commissioner Levin, I want to be very clear because you asked me, was it a breach for them to send that over? And I said no, and I believe that to be true. I believe in good faith an opposing party can send it back over and say that's not, you all may have known what you were thinking, but we didn't know what you were thinking and we don't agree to that. You understand? I mean, that's the way two parties can work sometimes, so I don't think it's a breach. I do believe, however, you all thought what you thought.
That's interesting, though, because how did they quote what they thought? I've never heard of $1.25 anywhere. Yeah. Even in the highest number thrown out there and before our contract ever expired and the mayor made an announcement to the media, that if we don't have some sort of agreement before that expires, that he is planning on raising it, or they are planning on raising up to $1 per thousand on the raw, and that was like enough to take everybody's breath, and now it's jumped to $1.25.
Because I would speculate and say it's because we never said we're taking it from their allocation. Again, it goes back to it's what they have, and if they give it to us, they don't have it anymore.
To sell somebody else.
That's right.
Ken, is there? I'll do my best to answer. I think because in the original draft from June 8th that I got from the city, the $1.25 wasn't in there either. And I I suspect it's because they feel like, with respect to a lot of this language, that they have agreed to discard it. I mean, I'm speculating too. I don't know. I'm trying to give you something because it wasn't in the June 8th draft.
That was their intention, and that's what their belief was. The get-go when they first got this, and they don't think that we made it clear enough, then why in their drafts, the original drafts, didn't it include it then, and why now? Because I don't believe it was in their mind either. I believe they just came up with this.
I don't think in their drafts, I think there was when you talk about the next component, I don't think they ever answered that until recently either, though. But we did, it was a fill-in-the-blank question, was it not, Councilman?
Sounds like seller's remorse, and they're just changing their minds as they go.
And again, this could all be moved. We get a permit tomorrow. We're talking about things that just don't matter.
I agree.
The next component was with respect to finished water. And this takes just a second of explanation. If you assume that we have the ability to draw down 16 million gallons at 10 cents per thousand as our first
day a month, is that correct?
Chunk. Right.
14.
That's our first, well, chunk of water. Then we have to buy roughly, on average, about 4.5 million gallons of finished, although that fluctuates, but just for purposes of easy math, let's assume that's how much we're buying on this typical day. So now you're at 20.5, roughly, of water. And let's assume that the Board of Commissioners said, well, we'll go ahead and agree to the 4.5 at whatever the rate. So that gets you up to 24.5 million gallons. All right, well, let's say you need more than that. Then what do you buy? And the city, I think, the answer would be, well, you're going to be buying, if you need more than that, you're going to buy finished water. Okay, you're going to pay $3 a thousand.
Is that an assumption, or did they say that?
They said that.
Is their intake big enough? Is their intake allocation big enough to support us getting 4.5?
Depends on what their usage is.
Well, I know, but we must have some.
It's very unlikely that we will go, I think, that we will go from the 16 million plus 4.5 raw plus then need to buy more finished. It is very unlikely.
In the next 5 years?
Period. Because they won't have it to give to us under their permit. And if their permit gets raised, our permit gets raised.
And we've got to keep working on raising our permit and probably expanding our plant.
So it's not as if their permit, I don't think, is going to get raised so they can sell us finished water. When we have the capability of finishing it ourselves.
Let me ask you this. Maybe you didn't mean to say this, but why is it necessarily that you said if their allocation is increased, so will ours be?
Well,
because the likelihood of EPD is not to destroy.
I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm just saying, is there a necessary linkage that I don't know about?
I just think that we make a good. We're the ones that are out.
Yes.
So in the first 2 minutes of this meeting, we talked about need.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So go back to the first 2 minutes, and we have the need.
And the EPD actually argued on our need in the federal case to get this. We're first on the list now. Our director's been told that. The question is, do we vote on this? Do we do something with this, or do we call a meeting and send a resolution?
Well, those 2 points are on the table. I mean, I've got an IGA that I prepared that I sent to the city that I would be very comfortable with the Board of Commissioners sending over to the city as an approved IGA in executable format. It's consistent with what the board approved. However, let's not put our heads in the sand. Since we know these two issues are out there, and since we know they've reviewed this, and since we know they've raised this issue, we can also know that if we just approve this one and send it over there, even if they approve it, we may just be kicking the can down the road where they're going to raise this issue at a future date and say the IGA doesn't speak to those terms.
Well, you're talking about the additional...
The two issues.
Well, do you think that we need to address them now and put them into a revised IGA?
You need to address what I have brought to you.
Why don't maybe we approve this and make an amendment. Amendment A that speaks to these two issues.
Yeah,
is that a way to do that? We'd like to have that approved at the same time.
I personally think you send it over one time, wait until they actually reject it, see what the rejection is. In the meantime, you get some resolutions done, set down to
resolutions
DCE
done.
And I understand.
This
should be sent over what we believe is aligned with our motion and the spirit of our motion. First, let them reject it before we start negotiating anything.
We've already done that.
Yeah, it's right.
We've negotiated and we've accepted and they've accepted. There are two outstanding issues.
Have they seen this?
And at the same time,
officially from our board?
No, not officially from our board.
But
we've been going back and forth. And again, this is a little bit of not a game changer, but this was a paradigm shift for me. This was a different approach because the elaborate agreement wasn't working. This is a streamlined agreement.
I think that we need to address the 4.5 MGD at about a quarter if we think that's the right thing. And number two is, in a nutshell, the second issue.
Whether or not we want to agree to pay $3 per thousand gallons on acquisitions of finished water over and above around 2014.
Which is unlikely.
I wouldn't even read that.
So I feel the same way about the wall, raising it.
They're all because of the
It's on their permit, I get it.
No. It's because we just don't use that much of it. It's an insurance policy.
Well, we're not going to use that much of that. We're not going to use any of the finished.
Well, then I'm not going to set the bar at $3.
Because we're going to use the other at, going to use the other
thing. I think we should set it at the same number. The more you buy, supposedly things get cheaper. So.
But again, they're taking their product, and they have it in limited
supply. Their raw product.
But let's sum up where we are now. We agreed to this almost 2 months ago. There are two outstanding points. They've kept the prices the same. But if we're not going to agree to something, the contract's expired. Then they're free to charge whatever we charge. Well, we sit around and look and work on resolutions because we're worried about paying four and a half million gallons of water that we just said we only use about seven days a year.
We're in July, so when do we start using more than the 14 to 16?
It's weather driven.
August, typically September, more often than not,
the peak days are in August.
And then we've had them in July, lowering what we buy from them.
If you buy it, the average price per thousand, if you buy 9,000, is $2.05 a thousand.
Tell me exactly what you'd like to do. You want to accept at $3.25 on the extra finished?
We never said $3.25 on the extra finished.
What was it, Ken? Three?
Three.
Is that what you want to do?
Because after you use up the extra 4.5 on the raw, it goes in that order. You use 16.
That call.
And we have a permit for 16 at no charge.
One day a month, peak.
Okay, 14 and 16. Right. Okay, and then we have agreed to buy on average 4.5. Right? Mm-hmm. So that's 20.5. Max.
No, we're not agreed to buy. They've agreed to make available if we need.
We've committed $1.6 billion.
I'm sorry.
Finished water. So that's 20.5.
For one day a month. Yeah, otherwise, it would be 18.5
Call it 18.5. And then they're going to make available to us 4.5 more. That's 23. We're skip 23 to 25, depending on the 23
right.
average.
Would you agree that should be a three or stay at the regular 2.5?
We're not even there yet.
Okay.
That's the finished. So right. How many times do we buy 23 to 25 million gallons of water a day? Once.
We haven't hit that in a few years.
And it was in 2006.
We hit 25 in 2006.
And everybody had an irrigation system. It was laying down sod.
Mm-hmm.
When do you?
Hold on, just a second.
I'm just trying to see what numbers you're comfortable with.
So
going in.
I think that what we're, you know, we did all the hard work is done on this motion that went across there. There are two items that we just never contemplated. How much we're going to pay for an extra fish?
In my mind, we set a raw and we set a finished.
Okay, but he's telling you right now they didn't break the spirit of the contract because we never sent that over.
But if this truly was in their mindset and they didn't agree with it, then why wasn't it come over? You're going to need a raise to get your glasses fixed.
My check.
Mine broke too. I can't get mine fixed either.
I would be willing to put the finished water back in the same rate. I
don't think they're going to be agreeable to giving up 4.5 million out of their allocation. That's 20%, 25%.
I'm about to finish over and above. $3. I just can't.
Well, why is it going up?
Okay.
Because they're already at the market.
Yeah, just leave it at the same rate. And I'd be happy with that.
Yeah, but again, that's not part of the motion. We've never contemplated.
Can I just say a couple things?
Again, I like him to tell you that we're not ever been to the point where we need that water.
Well,
23 to 25.
We will in next year.
23 to 25. Okay, so how much are we gonna make?
But that's a one-time thing, that's not based on this average.
That's right, it's the average, it's 1.6 billion a year. We don't use 4.5 million a day, that's the average all year. And what have we gone outside of that 1.6 billion? We haven't.
Ken, is there anything about agreeing to this, you know, step structure, if you will, that, I almost don't even know how to phrase this, that by in so agreeing to these higher prices for some reason, for raw and for finished water, that we have set a precedent about what it is we will pay for raw and finished water that could be a problem for us legally in the future that you can foresee?
Well, there's no question that if we approve that, it can be used as evidence against the county. I mean, that's just the facts. We've taken official action on the record.
No, I meant for future. I'm afraid, I don't want it to be somehow that the EPD says, you know what, you guys figured this out, we don't really need to get involved. And so, you know, now just continue at the $1.25 rate for your raw water.
Just for 4.5 million.
No, I don't think so, Commissioner, because you all are paying good and valuable consideration to require the city to join us in enhancing our EPD permits. I don't think EPD is going to have the luxury of saying that anymore, because we're going to be able to go to them and say we have the full support of the city to increase our allocation.
And I think is it also in any way possible to interpret this, that if we go ahead and do this, that it makes a real-time argument to the EPD of, we're already contractually into their allocation, or we could be into their allocation. How can you say you can't expand ours? We've had to get down and dirty this way to work around the fact that you won't regulate this thing properly.
And we may need to do that, but again, I think the best thing we can say is throw this IGA into the mix and say, we come to you seeking more water with the city's support.
We've got to do this, and then we've got to do that.
One thing
very quickly.
That's right.
So we offered them more money for certain items in order to get them to sign the IGA so that we could possibly go get more permits.
It may not even need to use the stuff that you're talking about.
We may never get there.
Yes.
We may never get to that 4.5 million, or we may never get to that additional finished.
Yeah, if that's the case, why are they trying to raise the amount on us? You pay it. We're not even going to get to it.
Because we've asked for a share of their allocation.
I understand.
So if they're going to give up some of their allocation, they can't.
Why should they sell their raw allocation for the same cost? I agree with that. I totally agree with that. But why hadn't the $1.25 come into play when their highest threatening amount ever was $1? How did now become $1.25?
Because the dollar was never part of their allocation.
It was part of our allocation.
That's right. They were going to sell us finished water out of our allocation. Now they're giving up some of their allocation. There's a big difference. I mean, we can't give allocation to anybody, right? If somebody came to us and said, hey, we want to buy 4.5 million gallons of water a day, how much will you sell it to us for? Our answer is, we can sell it for a penny or $1 million. We just don't have it. Right?
Yeah.
I need to address two points with you. First one is a practical one, and I very much apologize for this. I've got to leave at 4 o'clock, and I apologize because I've got to get to another meeting downtown, so forgive me for that at the outset. The second one is this. A lot of the assumptions we're working on here depend upon what, obviously, the city of Cumming is thinking as well. One of the things that has been very important to Tim is, particularly with respect to finished water, that historically, for the 20-some-odd years this has been in effect, we have been able to buy finished water really based upon the demand facing the county. So some days we would buy a lot more, and some days we would buy a lot less, typically buying less in the winter, more in the summer, which makes a lot of sense, right? You need that flexibility. But if we have this obligation to then buy entitlement, to buy 4.5 million of raw water at $1.25, I'm just curious how that looks, because Tim, you're going to be making the decisions as to how much finished water you're buying to meet the yearly obligation. When are you going to have a say, okay, today we stop at this number buying finished water, now I'm converting over to my raw water and I'm going to be buying that? What does that look like?
I mean, I just don't, that.
Do you buy it for 9 months, do you buy finished for 9 months out of the year and then go to the.
They track it on spreadsheets.
I think to be consistent with the contract, we keep having to try to hit these monthly targets. So I need, in 1999, which is what they sent over and what we agreed to buy, I think there is some confusion. The city maybe wants us to go with the annual average, 4.5. And anytime we're above 4.5, that's when the higher price goes in. But in July and August in 99, we got 7.5 for a monthly average. And we try to hit this. This is our graphs where we try to hit these amounts. In January, we only try to get 1.98 million gallons from them.
So you can manage it, though.
And that's so what that we can we've tried to do historically. And that's why we would continue to do it. I would keep trying to get 7 million gallons in August from them.
I'd just like to point out, based on what he just said, here's a possible scenario. You buy the finished at 225 through the month of August.
Whatever you start.
Yeah, then it's done. Then you go on to the raw. Then you go on to the raw at $1.25, and you're finishing it yourself for 60. You're getting it for $1.85. So you've just reduced your finished cost of water from them.
Well, why don't we just accept that? Why don't we make it offer back a little bit less than?
I think.
I'm happy with it.
Again, it's their allocation.
I understand.
I mean, what would you propose? It's their allocation.
At some point, if we don't accept anything, our needs even greater and possibly is more of an urgency PPD to give us a quicker.
So what do you want?
We got three minutes, and apparently we're going to lose Ken. Do we want to make a motion?
Where's Chris Hamilton? He'll hang with us.
Do we want to have a special session tomorrow?
I'll make a motion. I'll make a motion that's time sensitive that we, we've already made a proposal so that we add an amendment to the agreement presented to us by council.
This would be to approve the IGA in front of you, subject to any modification you choose to make.
We approve the IGA as presented to us by the county attorney. Do you need to put a date on this thing or exhibit number or anything like that?
It's the one. Cindy, do you have a copy of it?
I do.
I'm fine with that.
Okay. Subject to the following modifications that we, one of the terms of the contract was that we buy or can buy up to 4.5 million gallons on a 30-day average per day, and that we accept the price of $1.25 a thousand, and that we, if we go over our permitted amount and over the 4.5 million gallons a day, that if we needed to buy more finished, which is very unlikely, we would pay $3 a thousand. And that's time sensitive, and remind the board that it requires what, a 4-4-0 vote, and if it doesn't, then remind them that the contract's expired, and we're subject to a price increase.
I think they've already set the standards of what they're willing to sell to us for by sending us a bill already.
Do we have a second?
Wait a minute. Let's keep in mind that prices have stayed the same during this time where we're trying to finalize the contract.
Yeah, we have a motion and a second for discussion.
We're talking about, it's very unlikely that we would use that without that finished one.
For purposes of knowing the intent of the board, if we put that language in about $1.25, that is only $1.25 out of the city's allocation.
Out of the city's allocation.
Out of the city's current.
Current allocation.
Current allocation.
Not some future allocation.
It's their allocation, Todd. That's what I keep trying to tell you.
I'm talking about the finish. You did it at 3. It's not that.
That's what he said.
I'm doing it for 2.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further.
We have a second on Brian's?
Yeah, 2 seconds for discussion. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further.
You want to amend? Go ahead, amend.
Can I amend the motion?
Well, you're going to defeat his motion.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah. Just go ahead.
Can I try to amend it? And if he says it defeats it, then.
I'll tell you what. I'll withdraw my motion.
I'll withdraw my second.
Thank you.
And I'll make a motion that we accept the contract as presented by a counselor, subject to the following terms, that the county is able to buy an additional 4.5 million gallons per year out of the city's allocation at $1.25 a thousand.
Of raw water.
Of raw water. And that if we still need more water, I could be done. You know, let's just not even talk about it. Let's just not put it in.
That's not what I've been doing. I'm just really concerned that how we word this thing doesn't mess up Tim and how he can buy it. And when he's allowed to draw the line.
And then ask him.
I second it. Discussion so far.
Okay. Well, wait a minute.
Ken, you're not getting out here before you understand.
No, we're trying, Ken. We're trying.
This is not going to happen.
Let me finish the motion.
We've been doing this for 7 months.
If we go over
the additional 4.5. $2.50 for the additional finished on a CPI because the.
How much?
$2.50
on a finished.
Whatever we take after that, whatever they can.
Whatever we get. Sooner or later, they're going to run out.
Second on time sensitive basis.
I thought there was an amount to clear.
No.
Out.
Okay. No.
Or Ken, do you think you understand that motion? Cindy, do you think you have it down?
I'll have to listen to it on the tape.
Okay. Is that time sensitive? We have a motion and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, like sign.
Oh my gosh.
Look.
It's your baby.
Yeah.
I just don't believe that there's a difference in the numbers.
He just told you that it wasn't in the motion. He just told you that. I'm not telling you that.
He is. Look, and I'd be easier to believe that if they were sent over their first IGAs with the new numbers in there that they believe.
It's not that it was sent over. He and the city attorney have been working back and forth.
And never has it been in there until now.
Well, let me ask you a question. How many times have you gone over to talk about it? None. So you want it brought back to you gift wrapped.
Are you okay with the 125?
He voted for it. What do you mean? Is he okay with it?
And you just voted for the 250?
Yeah. Because I don't think we're ever going to.
We're never going to get there.
We're seldom if ever
get it. You're taking this deal on something we're never going to get there.
And if we do get it in any significance, it's because we were unable to get the EPD to give us what we need, and we're stuck
then. And that's not their fault.
What makes you think they won't accept the dollar?
I don't think it's enough to worry with.
Because I've gone over there and talked to them. That's my job.
And as Tim said, we don't need it that
because
often.
They're giving up their share of their allocation. It's not about they have it. If they give it to us, it's they don't have it anymore.
Why did you raise them?
I didn't raise it.
I didn't
raise anything.
You reduced it from $3 to
what they're asking for. I still think this true that motion was $2.25.
And this guy down here is telling you that's not it.
Even on the finished?
Again,
that's not
that contingency that the $2.25 talked about our mandatory commitment
of $1.6 billion.
We watched
the motion on the tape. He's got it in front of him down there.
Now, Commissioner Van, I'll say the same thing I said to you. If there had been another price term, I think this board would have thought of that.
Wish it were done, Todd. But it wasn't. So those 2 points had to be contemplated to fill in the blanks on the contract. I wish it were done, and we weren't here 60 days later. You're talking about tubing the deal for something we might not ever use.
We don't have that.
If we need that from them, there's our case to the EPD right there.
I know, but once they've agreed to say that's the water that you need, then your needs are not the great needs they once were. You've already got them covered through this.
No, this is a cobbled together plan.
And do we still have the need to say, hey, we need this now?
We do. We still have it because we've had to cobble together.
Do you think that our needs are still as strong as we accept buying this from them? As if we don't have the extra 4.5, say, hey, look.
If that is a concern, you could add to your motion that in no event is our willingness to pay for this construed as a diminution of our need for our own capacity. I mean, you could put that in the contract. Absolutely, we're doing it because we have to.
Then say that out loud.
Make a motion.
All right, I'll make a motion that we accept the IGA that attorney has drawn up and is sitting in front of us with the following amendment and following modifications, that the 4.5 million gallons of finished additional, well, I know the raw will be the 125, but you're also at the finished, extra finished you were talking about, 225 is my motion.
But with this not to be
You're never going to use it. Well, then don't worry about the amount.
Then just don't put it in the motion.
They're going to put it in there because they're going to take it.
Let's just not put it in there.
What makes you think they're going to set the 250 then? You only accept my motion and then beat me up. At least let's get the.
Well, you got the majority of the board to disagree.
Are you okay with 225? Yes.
With
asking for additional water from the city is not to be construed with our needs not still existing for the EPD and the ACE to give a storage area and additional water permits.
We could all vote for that, but that's not going to be accepted at 225. That's actually less. That's actually less. It'll be less in 5 years because the 225 we pay now has a CPI on it.
Okay. Oh, and the 225 falls in the same category as the same initial purchase of finished water with the CPI on it. It just needs to be aligned to make it simple on the billing, too.
Let me just recap.
It's going to be crazy on the billing for them to deal with.
Let me try to recapture it, Todd. The IGA is presented with an additional 4.5 MGD on a 30-day average with a buck and a quarter.
Yes. On raw.
On raw, yes. Anything above that?
Off the sewage permit only.
Okay. Basically, what you've said, then anything over that on finished water is under the same terms and conditions as the other finished water.
That is correct.
And that we have language that it doesn't diminish our desire or whatever discounts.
To get this.
Is that what you said?
Yes. And please keep in mind, if you start breaking up the.
And that was time sensitive.
And time sensitive.
So I'll second that for discussion.
Okay. My concern is they're going to start getting bills for this, and this is going to be lifting this, and this is going to be a nightmare.
I think as a matter of discussion, if you're going to try to do the 225 finished, then I think we ought to identify the order in which we are trying to purchase the water. We're getting the 16 million on our permit, max day. And then if we need the additional 4.5, we're getting that at $1.25. Oh, excuse me. $16 million, and then we're buying finished at 225 plus CPI. And then if we need additional above that, we're back to buying raw at $1.25 up to 4.5 million. And then after that, if we need more, we're back to buying finished at 225, which they're not going to have enough.
I just don't see when, and this is something I just may not understand, but I don't see when Tim stops the finished water purchase and starts the raw water.
It's going to be a nightmare. We're going to be in court.
I just don't understand. I mean, it's going to be a nightmare. I just don't understand.
They do that anyway. They track how much we use on a daily basis.
So you've got our permit. Then you got their 4.5, then we on finished, then we go to 4.5 on raw, then we go back to 4.5 on finished again?
Yeah.
We actually take the cities.
Is that a merger? Y'all understand that's part of this motion?
This is ahead of ours. We try to take our monthly quota from the city first, and we scale our plant, our treatment back, because we have to be able to try to hit this. Now, I don't think the city believes this. I think they think it's 4.5 annual average, but that's not. We've got a different opinion.
That's not what we've been practicing.
Well, but I keep hearing the 4.5. And then we take our plant up to our number. And if those two together won't meet our need, then we'd start getting raw. And then if that
4.5 out of their allocation.
And if we went above that,
we'd
try to go back to the city. But honestly, the city can't provide this. I don't think they could get it to us. They'd have to put in some system improvements to get any more, because they can't get this to us.
We'll probably have to go over there and negotiate it on a monthly basis.
Yeah, let's just leave that.
See what they have.
Which one do you want to leave off?
The finished, over above finished.
Mr. Chairman, I'm sorry.
He's got to go.
Please forgive me. I've got to go.
Can we get one more crack out of here?
One more.
Take 60 seconds.
So wait. So we vote.
I'll try. We accept the Forsyth County and the City of Cumming IGA that's been presented in front of us with the following amendments and modifications. And additionally, after we hit our 16 million on peak and the 14 million on the average, that we then purchase additional raw water.
Finished first.
Well, the finished is part of here.
Yeah, it is.
It's already in here.
If we need more.
Yeah. So then if we need more, we hit the additional raw on the city's permit only, 4.5 million gallons a day.
Up to.
No more than $1.25 a thousand without the CPIU.
Forgive me for that. You said up to, you mean at 125?
Yeah, no more than 125 with no CPIU. That's right. At 125.
Up to 4.5 MGD at $1.25.
$1.25. With this not being construed as us not desperately still need the same additional increased permits from the EPD and the will for the ACE to still give us our own storage area and access to the lake at some point in time.
Second for the second.
Time sensitive.
Second for discussion, just want to point out that the right to buy the 4.5 finished or raw comes after we buy the 4.5.
Why don't we
raw.
Say that the order in which he knows that.
We got
is
that.
Kit will be we're maximized okay. by 10.
Because I said after this.
We don't need that as part of the motion. It's purchase in whatever order he feels you need to buy it to maximize
the maximize our best. Yeah. Dollar.
But we still are committed to the 1.6 billion.
Yes.
We have a motion and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos recused. Is there any other business to come before this board, including
the let's add something on there, Ken. Will we add something, Ken?
Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
All those here for giving escort. See ya.
Do I hear a motion to adjourn the meeting? Do a motion to second if there's no further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
That's the other one. Pete, what would you say? I believe that was unanimous, and we're adjourned at 4:13 p.m.
Sorry to interrupt. You did a video of the town hall meeting for the Eagle Point.
Yes.
Have you?
I have not yet. I'm on vacation for a week, so I'm pretty backlogged on ideas, but I think you have it. I'll email you later on. Glad to. I went to North Carolina. North Carolina?
From nice. Oh, you went on vacation.
Yeah, I'm back.
Have a good day, man. We're going to get over the lots.
Yeah, I wasn't here, but
we had the most
Did I see you Saturday?
Where?
Manchester Road. I was standing outside the road. I saw you counting.
It's
somebody said that one day we'll look back and call this a campaign.
I
mean, it's big there for hell.
Jumped up and down behind that guy.
That was my talk.
How you doing? So you guys.
Yes, no, and Nydia.
I put my Superman shirt on.
There you go.
I think that's what came out.
That's all I was going to say.
What I'm talking about, in a nutshell, let's say, this is, I'm using round numbers, let's say, for purposes of brevity and simplicity, let's just talk about
can we take this into maybe individual offices or
who is that guy?
Oh, that's
Is that your official?
Is it Ken's?
That's Ken's.
The official meeting's over.
Yes.
Nobody will.
Ken just left without his briefcase.